Start this one.
All right. Did you copy it? Mm-hmm. Okay. Hello, everybody. Hello.
Let's wait for some people to join us.
Yeah, we'll wait just a few minutes for you all to join us here at the Old Presbyterian Meeting House. Hi, Judy Elmore, watching on our OPMH page, and Dave Hybe, I see you there watching on Suzanne's page. So, it's a little confusing to know what camera to look at here.
I know, we're on the OPMH page, and...
Yeah, so if you didn't get the memo about this, you can watch it either on Suzanne's page, which some of you are already doing. That's the camera I'm looking at right now. And you could also watch it on the OPMH page, which is the camera I'm looking at right now.
Oh, so you're watching on that one and Christine's watching.
So the sound will be a little different on each of them because we have the microphone set up with Suzanne's page and just the regular audio on the OPMH page. But just let us know that, whoa, I just hit my time. Just let us know you can hear us all right. We're gonna get started in just a minute. So if you wanna take a second to read the description the description of this video at the top, you can see that this is an official concert with a cause. Which is something that we do here at the church on a regular basis. We have concerts here. Sometimes it's just me playing the organ, or like tonight, the two of us. Sometimes it's with the whole orchestra and the choir and everything. And we designate a cause for each one of them. They're always a free concert, but then we have a free will offering to support one of the ministries here at the church. So I'll tell you a little bit about that in a minute, but you can check out the description. I think we should begin. We've got a lot of music to do tonight.
Yeah.
And we had lots of people request music that they would like sung or that they would like to sing along to. So we'll try to incorporate a lot of those pieces. And then we also promised some songs from different traditions. So we'll do some hymns, of course, that you all know and love. And we'll also do some songs in Hebrew from the Jewish faith that will be a lot of fun to do.
Kelly said hair looks great, Stephen.
Oh, thanks.
I want everybody to know that I cut Stephen's hair today.
That was quite an adventure. Yeah, I let Suzanne cut my hair, which is the first time she's ever done that. I won't show you the sides of my head, but the top is okay.
So mean.
No, she did a great job. She did a great job. If you've been watching these videos every day, you'll notice a marked difference from previous days. So I feel like a whole new person now. Okay, so we're going to start with a song that you all know and love. I guess you could sing along to it, but it's not intended for you to sing along to. And it's by a composer that we know and love very, very well. We even named our dog after him. So, should we do it?
Yeah.
All right.
Ave Maria.
Beautiful.
Nice one to start.
Yeah, beautiful one to start with.
Thank you, Hubert, for writing that one.
I'm just looking at who's watching and all the comments. So thank you for that. So that was Franz Schubert's Ave Maria. Very, very popular piece.
Yeah.
And originally, actually, an art song in German, and then it got some Latin lyrics, right? Interesting fun fact about that. So one of the things we promised in this concert is that it would be partially a sing-along. So hopefully you have a hymnal nearby that you can grab and sing along. If you don't, maybe you know all the words. Maybe you just know one verse. Whatever you want to do, we're fine with. And so we're going to start with maybe the most famous hymn of all time. I don't know. It's Amazing Grace. Yeah. In the Presbyterian hymnal and Glory to God, it's number 649 if you happen to have that. If you have the older blue hymnal, I don't know what number it is, but you can look it up in the index. And if you have some other hymnal, I guarantee you it's in there. You just maybe have to look it up in the index. So we're going to sing Amazing Grace. And the version we have has five verses. And I know that there are sometimes different ones, but just take a cue from whatever the first words of each verse are that Suzanne sings, and then you'll know where we are. Okay? Mm-hmm. Says that, Fred. I hope it's not frozen for everybody. Just let us know if the connection is not great.
I'm off the Wi-Fi.
So. Yeah, me too. So hopefully you were able to sing along with that. Amazing Grace. And now we're gonna do. I don't have my. My list is on my phone, which is being used right now. So what do you have next?
I have a Rosary Cross.
Okay, great. So we had this hymn requested by a couple of folks. It's not, as far as I know, in the Presbyterian hymnal, but it's in many other hymnals, and you probably know the words to this. We're going to sing The Old Rugged Cross. And so it might be in your index as the Old Rugged Cross, Old Rugged Cross, or maybe even On a Hill Far Away, which are the first couple of words. We're only going to sing the first verse and the last verse. It's quite a long hymn. So the first verse is On a Hill Far Away. The last verse starts with, To the Old Rugged Cross I Will Ever Be True. So if the verses are in a different order, you can find that, all right?
She said at times the sound is breaking.
Sound is breaking. It's too loud, maybe. Because we did move it up. So.
Okay, I'll move it a little farther away from me.
We're learning new things about how to do this every day, so.
It should be fine on the open page.
Yeah, okay. So I'm going to do an old rugged cross.
Which I've never sung.
What, now you have? Okay. Let us know how the sound is. I hope that it's okay. Okay, on the OPMH page, I hear video and audio great on this end. So let us know on Suzanne's page if it's okay. Not. People say you can hear us.
Yeah.
Hear us perfect. Okay, good. All right. So we're gonna do. Oh yeah, we're gonna do this song now. So we said we were gonna do some songs in Hebrew, and this is a really popular Shabbat song. Those of you that are in the habit of celebrating and singing can sing along with us. Even if you don't know this, there's a whole section of Lie, Lie, Lies in there, which you will catch on quickly. And this text is actually from a psalm. So if you've ever sung Bernstein's Chichester Psalms, which by the way is all in Hebrew, I know many of you choral people out there have sung it before. You have sung these words before. The name of the song is Hine Matov, right? How good it is for brethren to dwell together in unity is the translation of this. And it's really fun. There's actually two different versions of this that we're going to mishmash together. One is the kind of dancey one, and the other is a round. So when we get to the round section, you'll hear Suzanne and I both singing together. And if you pick up on that and want to sing along, great. And then we're going to go back and do the dance section again. All right? This is fun. Uh-huh. Yes, excellent. Yeah.
Good job, Patrick.
So there's lots of different versions of that, but we like those two. And did you catch on with the lie lies? I saw Laura, that's Suzanne's mom, saying lie, lie, lie. great. So the next song we're going to do is a super popular song from, I want to say, the 60s by Sidney Carter, who is a folk hymn writer. And it's called The Lord of the Dance. And there are lots and lots of verses to this. I believe it's in the Presbyterian hymnal, but I could be wrong. I know it's in many others. And you'll definitely, if you don't know all the verses, you'll catch on with the refrain, right? Dance, dance, wherever you may be. And the tune of this is the old Shaker hymn, Simple Gifts, which was made very popular by Aaron Copland. And we'll get back to him later. But this really, really fun version is arranged by John Rutter, who you all know from lots of fun arrangements and Christmas carols and whatnot. And yeah, So this is the Lord of the Dance. If you can find it in your hymn book, sing along. If not, just enjoy this.
There's a weird really, verse in there, though. So
yeah, it's a cool arrangement, and that definitely is painting the text of what's going on, as it's the narrative of Jesus's life, right? Mm-hmm. So okay, here we go. If you've never heard it, that's the arrangement by John Rutter of Sidney Carter's Lord of the Dance. Yes, thanks, Kate. Isn't it a fun arrangement? Next, do we have the same thing? Okay, yeah. Great. So this hymn was requested by
several people, right?
My mom first, and then by my Aunt Carol May. This is my dad's sister, and she told me that this was one of the hymns that she remembers her mom, my grandmother, singing all the time at the top of her lungs. So we're gonna do a fun arrangement that's, I would love to say it's completely mine, but it's not. It's actually by Craig Curry, who's done a lot of wonderful arrangements, and it's sort of in a jazz idiom, I guess, sort of.
Mm-hmm.
But you can still sing along to it. It's not too weird that you can't still sing along. So the name of this hymn is His Eye is on the Sparrow, and I'll give you a minute to find it in your hymn book. Again, I don't know if this is it. I feel like it is in the Presbyterian hymnal, but I didn't bother to check. I'm sorry about that. But you can look and see if you can find it. I know in some of the newer hymnals, including the UCC hymnal, it's called God's Eye is on the Sparrow. they want to remove the gender part of that, but His Eyes on the Sparrow is the name of this. The first line is, why should I feel discouraged? So it might be by that first line as well. And feel free to sing along. I think it's only one verse of this, and then the refrain repeats, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is His Eyes on the Sparrow, and then I think we're going to go do some stuff on the organ, which will be a lot of fun. And we're going to move all this equipment upstairs, so you don't have to give us a second. And I'll also tell you a little bit more about the charity Family to Family that this concert is in support of. So if you feel like donating already, please go to the description of this video, and you can either text to give, or you can go to our website and give that way. And I'll tell you more about that in a little bit. So this is His Eyes on the Sparrow. So that was His Eyes on the Sparrow, beautiful, beautiful hymn by Charles Gabriel, arranged by Craig Curry in this case. Great, and now we're gonna go to the organ, but maybe you can just say hello for a second. I have to grab my info. I forgot that I need to read you a little something before we go upstairs.
Oh, sure, I can show everybody Schubert. Yeah. We didn't have our Schubert meet and greet. So, for those who are joining from the OPMH page who might not have been part of our 30 Days of Music previously, we always have a moment for our dog to say hi. So this is that moment. While Steven's pulling up, what are you pulling up, the Family to Family?
Yeah. It's on my phone, which I always count on having right there with me, but it's streaming the video right now, so obviously I can't do that.
He's really heavy though. Heavy boy.
So thank you for joining us again. Like Suzanne said, this is part of our 30 days of music that we've been doing every night on Suzanne's page. A lot of you are watching there. I think we have 50 people, oh my goodness, watching on that page, and 26, 27 on the other page, on the OPMH page. I'm glad you got the notification. We're trying this out with double streams tonight. So I just wanted to tell you a little bit about the Concerts with a Cause again, especially if you're joining us late, and especially about the cause. I'm gonna kneel down here if that's all right. So we do these concerts periodically throughout the year. They're called Concerts with a Cause. We do them for free here at the church at the Old Presbyterian Meeting House. That's where we are right now, if you didn't know. And each one of them is designated to support one of our missions, one of our ministries in the church. And so we have a free will offering for those concerts. And we were to have a concert on, I don't remember the date now, March 20 something, March 22nd maybe, to do Mozart's Requiem with the orchestra and choir and all that, which would have been such a great event. It will happen, but it's being postponed obviously due to the coronavirus. But we didn't get a chance to have that and to raise funds for one of our ministries. And also along with that, we were supposed to have this wonderful gala that we have every year, usually at the seminary down the road here, to support, to raise funds for Family to Family Ministry, which is one of the main ministries here, one of the ones that's hosted by the church and supported entirely by the church. And if you don't know about it, I'm just going to read you the little blurb that we have on our website. You can find more about this if you go to opmh.org and then click on serve and look at our service and justice listings. So here's the little blurb from the website. At the heart of our local mission work is the Family to Family Ministry, which provides emergency financial assistance to those in our community. Through the Family to Family Ministry, the Meeting House works collaboratively with area social workers to help meet emergency financial and health care needs among the working poor. Working through these social workers, Family to Family is able to provide assistance of up to $150 every 4 months. Recent examples include helping with an electric bill so the client could have dentures repaired, paid for college transcripts for an ex-offender so she could qualify for a job, and another example was help with money to buy uniforms so the client could begin working. That's kind of the nuts and bolts version of what Family to Family does. I get to hear a lot of what goes on in Family to Family Ministry, because my office is right next to the office for Family to Family, and we have volunteers that are running that program, during the week when I'm there in my music office playing music and stuff. And then I just have a little blurb, that 2020, this year, is actually the 50th year that Family to Family has been helping our needy neighbors with emergency financial assistance. And what was going to be a great anniversary celebration this year, of course, has been stalled by COVID-19. And particularly right now, as you can imagine, there are so many in our community that need extra help, because, you know, they don't have benefits in normal times, and now they have no funds for seeking healthcare services. And people that like cook and clean and do landscaping and construction jobs might be frightened to access government assistance. And so we're really trying to help those folks out. So if you feel inclined to give, please look at the description in the video. You can text to give, or you can go to opmh.org. And I'm blanking on what the link is right now, but it's right in the description. And you can go to that page. And give whatever you feel like. And if not, this is a free concert, and we just love that you're here watching with us. So we're gonna travel now to the organ upstairs, and you probably should put Schubert down so he can carry everything. And we're gonna continue with the music. So if you missed the very beginning, you should you need a hymnal. If you want to sing along with some of these, unless you are one of those people that knows every word to every hymn. And while we're doing this, I'll try not to drop anything. You're going to get a little preview of the church, or just a glimpse into it if you haven't been here in a while. And we're moving pretty slowly because we don't want to drop anything. Yes, you can see the microphone there.
Trying to aim it towards you.
So I know a lot of you haven't been in the church in a long time, and I know we will be here soon enough gathering in person to worship and enjoy all the wonderful things that go on here at the meeting house.
Hi, Amy.
Oh, hey, Amy.
Mid-transition.
Amy actually used to sing here, right? I couldn't verify, but I'm pretty sure he used to sing here, doing what Suzanne does now. Oh yeah, if you didn't know that Suzanne is the current soprano section leader here, we have three other wonderful section leaders that have been helping us put together recordings during the week for our online worship offering. And the whole choir has been participating and sending their own recordings that I put together to be one big virtual choir. So we can still have music in our worship. All right, we're here. We made it. So the first piece we're going to do up here is a famous Latin work by César Franck, a French composer. I'm going to take my shoes off.
All right, I'm going to move this.
Yeah, whatever you think. Let the stand is blocked. The other stand is blocked.
Oh, I see.
Oh, so you can be seen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Beautiful. I haven't done that in a while.
Yeah. Okay, now time for a hymn sing. Can you all hear okay? Can you just confirm? Especially if the organ is too loud, I'm not sure. But we're going to sing in Glory to God in the Presbyterian hymnal. This is number 836, Abide With Me. We had a couple of requests for this beautiful hymn. And if you were here in October for the adult ed that I ran on Wednesday evenings, you'd know that this is one of my favorite hymns. And actually is missing a verse or maybe two verses from the original, but it's just such a beautiful hymn. And we're gonna do all the verses. And the Presbyterian hymnal has five verses. We're gonna sing all of them. All right, so 836, you can find it in your books too. Singing along, let us know. Are you looking at the comments? I wondered if the organ was too loud there, but okay, good. We're gonna do another song in Hebrew. This one is called in English, Jerusalem of Gold. And if I have the story right, was nominated or written to be Israel's national anthem. It wasn't picked, but it's still a beautiful song. I wouldn't say technically it's like a religious song, but it has quotes from Book of Lamentations and some other places, and it talks about restoring Jerusalem, mm-hmm. right? It's just a beautiful song. And I never played this on the road. It's definitely in everybody's hymn book, so look up Great is Thy Faithfulness. It's number 39 in the Glory to God hymnal. It has three verses in that book, so we're going to do three verses of Great is Thy Faithfulness, number 39 in Glory to God.
Thank you.
And now we're going to do, in glory to God, it's number 840-840. And it's called It Is Well With My Soul. Although in our hymnal, it's listed by the first line of the hymn, which is When Peace Like a River. So in your hymn book, if it's not Glory to God, it might be listed by When Peace Like a River or It Is Well With My Soul. And lots of folks asked for this. And maybe you all saw that wonderful video right when this outbreak started. All these Nashville studio musicians made a virtual choir arrangement of this. And it's so beautiful. If you haven't checked it out yet, please do.
Yeah, Mary, that was my favorite line.
What?
She said, a bright hope for tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh, that's such a beautiful line. So for this hymn, we're just going to do the first and last verse. So when peace like a river, and then the last verse starts with, Lord, hasten the day when our faith shall be sight, right? So just those two verses. All right, please sing along. It's just such a wonderful hymn. And actually, I think some of you asked for it. I don't know. I just blanked doing this. So this one in your Glory to God is number 625. And it's, again, listed by the first couple words. O Lord, my God, the name of the hymn is How Great Thou Art. Right? And we're going to do all the verses, yeah?
One, two, and four.
So we're going to do three verses of this, one, two, and four. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder. Second verse is, when through the woods and forest glades I wander. In the last verse, when Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation. Okay, with shout of acclamation, singular. I just messed that up. Okay.
Stars.
What?
I was like looking for your cutoff
through the camera. Oh, I don't know if I'd be able to for that one. Okay, now we're gonna go back downstairs and do a couple more pieces to close. Thanks so much for joining us so far. We've got a couple more pieces for you, so stick around. And we're gonna
commercial
go downstairs.
Break.
And yeah, commercial break. This is like we have two quasi intermissions as we travel. Thanks, Cheryl. There's so many wonderful new people that we've met through doing this, met virtually, I suppose. Some of you know the story already, but you know, we were getting quite a few viewers on Suzanne's 30 Days of Music every day. But then you posted a photo and view from my window, which is a group that has, I don't know how many people on it, millions of people.
Yeah.
And we got a bunch of new viewers from that. So some of you found us from that, which is so great. And some of you, it's just kind of the word has spread a little bit.
Or maybe the WTOP, I don't know.
Oh yeah, and some of you heard us the other day on WTOP. We were featured briefly on a segment that was playing on the hour, not on the hour, but every hour. A couple of days ago. And then there was an article in the newspaper just about what we're doing. And one of the questions was, do you think you're going to stop after 30 days? And we had talked about, you know, this is already, what is this day? 28.
Two more days.
And it just feels so wrong to end in just a couple of days. We've had so much fun doing this. It's a lot of work, but it's also a lot of fun and so rewarding to see all you join and comment. And we get to interact a little bit, even though we can't physically be there with you.
Wish you all were actually physically here.
I know. We wish you. We were commenting how before we started, it was so weird to be setting up for a concert and dressing up, and there's nobody here physically in the church. But Schubert's here. Hey, Schubert.
He's wagging his tail.
So, without further ado, I think we'll just continue with the music. Again, check the description, and if you feel like donating to our Family to Family program, please do that. This video will be saved afterwards. You can watch it as many times as you want.
I think some
and sing
at
along.
OPMH want to see the church. I have to turn the camera around.
Oh, the people at OPMH? I'm only going to move one of these cameras, I guess.
I can show this briefly.
So
if everyone wants to see, oh, I can only do
this is the
way.
Beautiful church.
If you want to see where we've
I don't been really know what I'm showing, but this is the.
We haven't really given this away.
This is the church. Yeah.
This is
Suzanne showing everybody what's going on.
What is this organ called?
This is the Urban organ by Henry Urban. Yeah. Don't get to hear that today, but okay. Oh, somebody said, I heard about this virtual concert from Central Presbyterian Church in Austin, Texas. That's so wonderful.
Oh, yeah, which we're going to be doing.
Is that the church? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so lots of wonderful things have come out of this, including we're going to give a concert on, is that on Zoom, right?
Yeah, that will be on Zoom.
Doing a concert on Zoom at another
church. Kind of gave me the idea that it'd be really cool to do our shows on Zoom. Oops, I'm trying to lift this, sorry.
All right, we're an hour in. I'm just conscious of time. I know lots of you don't have any qualms about this going really long, but we do want to keep going. So this is a beautiful hymn. I don't know who wrote this. I forget now. I think it might be a Robert Lowry tune. I'm not sure. Called At the River. Shall We Gather at the River? And this is the really famous arrangement. I lost you there, sorry. Famous arrangement by Aaron Copland from his Old American Songs. Thank you. Yeah. Oh, that's not a good answer.
That's okay, I can do this.
Okay.
I can see your head. Crystal tide forever, flowing by the throne of God.
that's the, in the choral version, it goes up at the end like that. Yeah. there's a famous choral version of that too. What do you have next in yours? Oh yeah, right, okay.
Yes,
so somebody asked for Every Time I Feel the Spirit, and it got me thinking right away of this wonderful medley that I knew by Mark Hayes, wonderful arranger, that has that song, Every Time I Feel the Spirit, which you can find in your books, I'm sure, and another old, I don't know if it's a spiritual or gospel song or whatever, but called Gimme That Old Time Religion. So there's a little bit of each of those in this wonderful song. So sing along if you know either of those. It's a really fun arrangement. Some of that. I know it kind of goes off the rails there at the very end, but what a fun arrangement by Mark Hayes. Okay, and now we're going to do another hymn that a couple of people asked me for. Again, I'm sorry, not in the Presbyterian hymnal, but you probably know this anyways. And I was just remembering a joke that I heard about this a long time ago. So maybe some people are watching from St. Joe's, where I was the music director before I came here. And one of the priests who was there, Father Gus, always used to tell a joke at the beginning of every sermon, whether you liked it or not. And many of them were hilarious. And some of them sometimes had to do with things of the church, and some of them had nothing to do with anything. But one of the ones that he told one time was, there's a Sunday school room, and the Sunday school teacher is saying, does anybody know what we call... you know, the man who lives upstairs? And people were saying, oh, well, I call him God, I call him Lord, I call him whatever, all the kids were saying. And this kid goes, no, that's not his name. And the teacher says, what's that? And he says, his name is Andy. And the teacher says, I'm sorry, how do you know his name is Andy? And he says, and he walks with me, and he talks with me. So we're about to do In the Garden, if you didn't get that. All right.
So funny. You didn't even tell me that story ahead of time.
Oh,
So that was two verses of In the Garden. Oh, Judy, that's so beautiful. Hey, Tim, nice to see you. From St. David's in DeWitt. That was my first like real church job that I had when I was just a senior in high school. So hi to folks at St. David's if there are others watching. I don't know. That's great. Now we're going to do one final Hebrew song. This one is called Dodi Li, which in the longer translation of it is, I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. It's from the Song of Songs. And I can't really remember because the day was a little bit of a blur, but I remember in our wedding ceremony, we said something like this. Yeah. I was like, repeat after me, the rabbi said. And yeah.
I think that was us saying, something. I don't know.
Yeah. It was at the very end of the ceremony.
Yeah.
And everybody was really surprised that I could say those words. So, but this is a beautiful wedding song, anyways. Dodi Li.
Oh,
finally, we have for you, because unfortunately it's time to say goodbye, and we have our last final song. Before we do the last song, I keep hitting my tie here. Before we have our last song, now you're doing it. Just want to remind you again, this is a concert with a cause. So obviously free for you to watch here and rewatch as many times as you want. We'll post this as soon as we're done singing and talking to you, and you can watch it as many times as you want. But do check out the description. This concert is being hosted to promote and to raise funds for Family to Family, which is a wonderful program we host here at the church that helps the working poor in Alexandria, in the city that we're in right here. It's they're in dire need of funds right now. As you can imagine, there are so many people that need help that are less fortunate than us, especially at this time. And we weren't able to have our big gala that we have. It's a really fun party that we have every year for Family to Family. So we would love for you to contribute as much as or as little, whatever as you can, to this wonderful cause. We're just really happy that we could bring people together to do this. And I see there's even more people watching than there were before, which I'm really surprised now being an hour and whatever, 15 minutes in. So we have one final song for you, and it's, I don't even remember the number in the hymn book, but you probably know it from memory. It's called God Be With You Till We Meet Again. God Be With You Till We Meet Again. We're just gonna do one verse. And we're going to do the ending that I grew up singing in the United Methodist Church, which has, till we meet, which has to be some kind of Baptist ending, I don't know. But it's a fun ending. So please sing along with us, God Be With You Till We Meet Again. Thank you for joining us tonight. Check out all our other videos and watch this as many times as you want.
You're not in this video at all.
Oh, I'll watch this as many times as you want. I'm talking to the OPMH one.
If anybody needs a haircut, I did this. Is that why you had the camera? You wanted the camera
no
to be
comment.
On the other side?
No, I'm just kidding. It was a great haircut. Okay, good night, everybody. We'll see you soon.